play, and I play for the U.S. Sitting Volleyball team. And it's here every time afterwards, the U.S. Sitting Volleyball team.
Yeah, starting off, we had more trouble than we were expecting, and really we just pushed through the whole day. There wasn't a game that was necessarily easy, and we ended up getting home.
And then for me, we kind of strategized everything, whereas we had a game plan going into each and every set, so we kind of knew what pace we were both on, and that kind of led us to getting home.
I was really proud of us for not getting upset or frustrated, and that we were able, and then we were able to come back in the third set and win.
That was amazing, but it kind of kept positive. I kept on doing a good job. We just kind of kept it together, making good plays, so it felt really good.
I've been playing for 9 years.
I've been playing in the Warriors in August.
When I started, I was 12 and was not very good and had no idea how to move. So I think I'm still learning, but now I feel like I've gotten a lot better and it's been fun.
I started at 18 when I first started, and I became a resident to help me with my movement. I'm still working. There's still so much that I need to do, but I'm pretty satisfied where I am there now.
I think sitting volleyball is for everyone. It's not just for disabled people, but it's also for able-bodied. It really does help with your standing game. I played sitting and standing on my standing game, so I think every team should be encouraged to sit down and play the game, and yeah, it'll help your standing game.
Yeah, I also don't think you have to be disabled at all to play the game. I think everyone should just try it in your living room, and at your gym, at school. I just think that everyone needs to try it. It's super fun.
Thanks for having us here. Thanks, Steve.